Hey there, fellas. Today I suggest we have a little fun. You know, like we usually do. You do see what we've laid out here on the hood of this car, right? And you can probably tell that this car is new. I meant to say that we bought it just recently. Specifically for this very experiment I'll be conducting today. The car... it's in pretty decent shape. As far as the bodywork goes, at least it isn't smothered in bog. Pretty much all of the panels here are in okay condition. The only exception being the underbody and the rocker panels. There's nothing you could do to bring them back to life. Up here, though, it has held up quite nicely, given its age. I'll start by telling you what exactly I have in mind. I'm very keen to try... I'm interested... to see how long... it would take... for a car to rust if it didn't have any paint. As in if it just had bare metal. So as you can see, we've bought some safety gear, some gloves, goggles, a bunch of spatulas, and a big thanks to Igor for providing us with some paint thinner, which we will be using to remove the paint from this car. So we start by removing the paint, then we get the car outside. The weather is just perfect for this sort of thing. We've been seeing rain and snow, so I'm guessing it won't take long for this car to start rusting. After that, well, you guys just keep watching and you'll see. Enough talk, let's do this. Stripping the paint off a Lada. For what purpose? Translation and voiceover by BMI Russian. Okay, fellas, so here's what we're looking at. We were told that we should apply the paint thinner using a handheld spray bottle. We actually broke ours. Whatever, it happens. So then we took the brushes out and... it's not the best way to go. I mean, it works, but you don't get the full 107%. Maybe somewhere closer to 50. Anyway, we've replaced the nozzle, and now we are back in business. It turns out that you don't even have to scrape anything off. All you have to do is apply the paint thinner, and here's what you end up with. The paint just falls right off. Works like a charm. You don't really have to do anything else. It just falls right off without any persuasion. And you're left with just the bare metal. Even if there is a tiny bit of paint left somewhere, You just apply some more, and here's another thing. You shouldn't do this in a rush. After you spray it on, it might seem as if something's happening. However, you should wait until the chemicals do their thing and remove the paint from the metal. I'm talking paint, primer. It also cleans the bog off, which is pretty nice. You should wear a mask when using this stuff. I mean, the smell is just nasty. Even when you so much as talk, this stuff gets on your tongue. And that doesn't feel good at all. You don't even need the spatulas. All you need is a brush, a pretty rigid one at that. And you just... That's all you have to do. You're good. There are some bits and pieces left here and there. But the paint does come off quite nicely. This is actually pretty simple. But don't forget about proper ventilation, safety gear, as in some gloves, protective goggles, and a breathing mask. And do not touch this stuff. It will eat your fingers away. And breathing it in, despite it almost having no odor, it stings like hell. You feel it in your nose. So yeah, guys, safety first. Right, let's keep going. All right, fellows, here's what a car looks like without its paint. You can say that it's sort of a metallic color now. That's the color of bare metal. We haven't used any degreaser yet, so this is what we're looking at. As for our plan, we're going to take this car outside, where we've been seeing some rain, some snow here and there, and that's despite this video having been shot in May, and we just let it sit. Maybe we find a way to install some cameras and film the car from all sorts of angles, so that we can at least be able to observe the entire corrosion process. Go ahead and subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss anything. Leave some comments and suggestions, hit that like button, and don't forget we have a VK public and an Instagram account. So yeah, subscribe, leave those comments and suggestions, give us a thumbs up. See you later, guys!